Hurricanes, then I want to see what Tucker Carlson's up to, okay? Because it seems like he's got some really good coverage going on. I have to see this, okay? I have to see what's happening here.
So this week, video surfaced on the internet from a place called Trafalgar High School in Oakville, Ontario. That's right across the lake from Niagara Falls. These videos show a teacher called Stephen Hanna, who apparently has been employed at Trafalgar High for several years. Recently, Hanna decided to dress like a woman, or more precisely, as a grotesque caricature of a woman, not a real woman, but a kind of pneumatically inflated Marilyn Monroe lookalike. As part of his costume, Hanna strapped on a pair of gigantic prosthetic breasts, each the size of a 10-pound watermelon. We're not exaggerating here. They're visible from at least 100 yards away, if not from space. We'll show you the picture. We are right now.
Tucker Carlson's like, why are M&Ms no longer fuckable? Also, why is this woman's titties making me feel the way I'm feeling right now? After all, in America, feminism has made titties smaller. But here in Canada, just across the pond, it seems like titties are only getting larger. Why am I feeling like I want to say awooga as my tongue slides down my chin, as my chin hits the ground? My jaw hits the ground and my tongue rolls out like a red carpet as my ears start blowing steam. And you can hear it like the horn of a train. Awooga, awooga, I say.
Now on the screen. But here's the thing. Hanna isn't doing this in private, in his home, in restaurants and clubs. If he were, we would not be mentioning it on the show because it would not be our business. Have fun. Stephen Hanna. No, Stephen Hanna is doing it in class, in front of children. As the Canadian journalist Jonathan Kay put it, Hanna has been dressing like this for a while, but only recently have students within the school gone public with this fact. So they've been enduring this for a while. Kay also notes that Hanna's costume is based on a style of Japanese internet pornography.
Stop. Please stop. What the fuck is going on in this fucking news story? No. Stop it, dude. There's a hentai mention? Are you telling me 75-year-old racists all across the country now know what hentai is? Before, like, New York Times liberals, dude? Now, I don't know. I don't know what the deal is, okay? I mean, Lord forgive me, but those titties are obscene, okay? They are. They're obscene. Those are not even Magumbos, okay? Those are not Nancy Pelosi's, dude. Those are not your average. Okay? I'll just state it. I'll say it like it is. Calling balls and strikes, okay? Those are some fucking yowzers, dude. Holy fuck! Okay, Nancy Pelosi. Anyway, this story might be enough for Haas and Ivan for today. No, I mean, those are some yiddies, okay? Those are, they're, this is like, this literally looks like a meme. Okay, this entire sequence, a very real sequence of the Tucker Carlson broadcast, looks like some shit that like an irony poison leftist would put together, by the way. Like, it just looks like a shit post. I can't understand how, oh my God. Anyway, all I'm going to say is this, okay? All I'm going to say is, I don't know what's going on. There's usually, whenever there's like teachers like this involved, or whenever they fuck, like 4chan will find like some rando, right? Going fucking crazy on the timeline. It'll go on TikTok, right? And then they'll turn around and like, they'll turn it into like transphobic shit, right? More info. Ontario transgender high school teacher wears massive fake breasts to school in front of young students. Wait, what the fuck? Bro, what is this person doing? I mean, what is this person doing? That's crazy. That's nuts. That's nuts. That's crazy. That's like, okay. I can't even speak, dude. What the fuck? Those are concussion-inducing breastises. You fucking smack someone on accident. Like, someone would be like, teacher, and then she turns around, blammo, fucking dead. You got dead students now, okay? You made him concussed. What are you doing? What the fuck? I can't speak, too bricked up from finding out Tucker knows about hentai. That's a sign of a good shop teacher. They look sturdy with a good choice of strong material. People in Ontario believe they're trying to get fired so they can get dollars on the school board. Yeah, probably. Anyway, is this real? I refuse to believe this. Man, I'm going to tell you, those titties are not. But story might be. But like, my son's teacher said to get his eyes checked because he has to be moved to the front every day. Yeah. Except when you sit in the front, you're concussed for sure. Because those titties have the circumference to fucking hit you while you're writing on the fucking board behind you. Okay, somebody calls you out, you turn around from the fucking blackboard, boom. One titty hit one child, the other titty hit another child. Okay? That's crazy. But like, do conservatives think all trans people have gigantic whale tits now? Yeah, like, what is the argument here? Like, what are they saying? Trans people are getting gigantic breast disease. Yeah, you can be a weirdo, man. It's fine. Like, yeah. You look hard enough, you're going to find some fucking weirdos who are trans, okay? Like, doesn't mean anything. What's the argument here? Like, what the fuck? Oh, Jesus Christ. Mr. President, a second titty has hit the building? No, I mean, I see it. Warmington, Halton School Board. First of all, what the fuck is Warmington? Like, the name alone is just like, that's not real, okay? Halton, Warmington. Halton School Board prepares for... prepares for backlash over trans high school teacher. First of all, it's not because she's trans, man. It's because she's got fucking gigantic titties. Just say it as it is. Like, what the fuck? Why are people being like, wow, it's really fucked up that, you know, this is transphobia. It's like, no, it's just like, it's titty phobia, if anything. The Halton District School Board is standing behind an accepted transgender... Wait, what? What is this? Dude, this is the most right-wing fucking news... What? Is this a part of, like, The Sun? Like, the Sun franchise? Because they're standing behind an accepted transgender teacher who's gone viral in social media video posts? Like, what the fuck? Bro, you're a newspaper. Who writes like this? Standing behind. That's crazy. Okay. In addition to the HDSB chair, Margot Shuttleworth. Okay, these are not real names. I'm sorry. Tells the Toronto Sun, the staff are looking at... This is where someone's going to say Shuttleworth is actually an Indigenous last name, and then I'm going to get owned. But regardless, it seems like a fucking AI-written article, okay? It literally just seems like J.K. Rowling wrote this article to, like, induce more transphobia, to create more, you know, transphobic people or something. Like, like the names seem like they were written in a Harry Potter book. Tells the Toronto Sun that staff are looking at going through a creating a safety plan to ensure the Oakville Trafalgar High School teacher security as they prepare for potential. Bro, no, they're looking to create a safety plan for the children, okay? They're looking to create a safety plan because the titties are blocking out the sunlight. Kids haven't seen sun in a year. There's no vitamin D. They got vitamin D deficiency. What is happening here? Kids are concussed, man. Protecting any person's gender rights is the same stance the school board has taken, and they're standing behind a teacher. Pre-transitioning, the teacher was known to students and faculty as a male and went by a man's name, but the teacher now identifies as a woman and is referenced with a female name. Like, the part about this is, like, the thing that's weird about this story is not that, like, the teacher is trans. You know what I mean? Like, you can be trans and be a teacher. The part of the story is so obviously how gigantic her fucking titties are. And it's just, like, it's blowing my mind that they're, like, so desperately trying to be like, yeah, you know those trans teachers, am I right? They all get these big-ass fucking bazookas. Like, it's just, that's it. It's the titties. Nothing else. And it does feel like, it does feel like she's just trying to get fucking fired or some shit. You know what I mean? And you can be a trans person and a weirdo on top of that. Right? Like, that's, you know. The Teachers Union Ontario are crack, non-derogatory. No cisgender woman would get titties such as this. No, they would, and they do, and then, but, like, we do look at them like they're fascinating, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, I mean, don't act like anyone looks at this and goes, oh, that's normal. Like, no one says that, dude. This is fucking insane. She's out here looking like a Hittite, you know, fertilization god or some shit. Fucking goddess of pregnancy. All the kids really love being in the class. School board says it sees her simply as a good teacher. This teacher who teaches shop is an extremely effective teacher. All the kids really love being in the class. Yo! What the fuck? Bro, that's crazy. I can't believe they wrote this article, dude. But videos posted to social media showing the Oakville Industrial Arts teacher who began identifying as female last year, appearing in class with large prosthetic breasts while operating a circular saw, has created much commentary. That's crazy. This is an insane story, okay? And the NGO all over the story, of course. Never waste an opportunity where people are having fun. Never let that go to waste. You gotta turn this into fucking you gotta turn it into some transphobic shit, you know what I mean, with your psychotic audience. Didn't the other article say she was wearing the breasts, or they're like fake titties? Yeah. Teacher looks like he could be one of Uzui's wives. We're going to finish the Tucker Carlson clip in a second. I got to see this. Bro, okay. I'm not going to lie. As the shop teacher, like, that does constitute like a safety problem. Like, you're working with like saws and shit all day, you're gonna cut the titty off on accident, okay? That's like this is one of those, isn't, not to be ableist, but that's kind of unsafe, man. Get OSHA on the line. What the fuck's going on? Those titties are not OSHA approved, okay? That's not. Oh, no. OSHA comes in, says you need to put a hard hat on each titty. Yo! Oh my god. Oh, you got steel-toed boots, now you got fucking steel-toed pasties for your nipples. Steel pasties for the nips. Azan, careful, you're about to be canceled. Absolutely zero people would look to this and be like, wow, this is so crazy. Like, come on, dude. We all got eyes, man. That's insane, okay? Like, come on. It would automatically be transphobic if I didn't make fun of her for getting the most ginormous titties that you've ever seen, okay? Like, just because someone is trans doesn't mean that they're going to get babied. Like, her existence as a trans woman is valid. Those titties, as a shop teacher, not as much. Okay? Come on. Let me enjoy this moment. Bro, she has a hard time turning, dude. Look at that. Oh, no. Yeah, she doesn't even need the saw. She can break the board with them titties. She can just drop one. Oh, that's so good. Some of the photos of the Canadian trans teacher who wears extremely large breasts. Prosthetic with protruding nipples, like, that's crazy. That's just unacceptable. I don't think anyone thinks that that is acceptable. Come on, dude. As a result, Shuttleworth says she articulated to those who run the board's day-to-day operations that we just can't wait around and see what happens because I'm quite confident it won't be a normal return to school Monday. To be fair, I don't even know if there are bras that size. Like, what do you do in that situation? You need, like, 8 bras attached to one another. Pretty sure those are prosthetics, right? They're not from a surgery. Yeah, I don't think you can get that. Like, she was like, give me the maximum dose. They were like, hey, ma'am, we're going to do HRT for you. How much would you like? She said, all of it. She said, all of the HRT. Okay, do you understand? I want literally every estrogen. I want all of it. No, you can't even do that. It doesn't work that way, man. Maximum progesterone dosage. I don't think you can do, like, I don't think you can, no matter how much HRT you do, you still need, like, plastic surgery on top of that. There's just no way. That's crazy. Oh, Jesus Christ. HRT, huge ridiculous titties. So stupid. She broke the titty slider in the character creator. Oh, okay, okay, that's... Oh my god, that's crazy. That's wild. Dude, the weirdest part about all this is that, like, like, women that have breasts that size, you know what I mean? Like, cis women that have breasts that size, like, they have to get titty reduction surgery because that is backbreaking, okay? Like, that's literally just straight up. Like, you have boobs that size, you're fucked. It is so bad. Your back is fucking done. Your neck is done. She's out here like, nah, I'm carrying that. Also, how much money do Canadian teachers make? Like, that's like a lot of plastic surgery. I feel like... like a good, they must be caked up out there. So good on them. Good on the Ontario Teachers Union, you know? Respect. Anyway, not tons, Lamau. 60 to 90K. Bro, 60 to 90K? You said not tons. Up to 90K a year after 10 years in the Toronto school. Bro, in Oklahoma, they get paid with a slap in the face. They teach Oklahoma, they give Oklahoma teachers the like $20 and a fucking Costco gift card. The fuck do you mean? Not a lot. Oh, it's Monopoly money. That's Canadian money. So what is that, like $5? Never mind. Yeah, teachers in America get paid in with wishes. Discord said this was okay to link, but maybe just open off stream first. Yeah, no, that is not okay. Dude, come on, bro. Dude, those fucking nipples are literally cutting through the shirt. And also my monitor, okay? It poked me in the fucking eye, dude. That's crazy. Like, I just, my tertiary monitor is broken now. It broke through the fucking glass. Anyway, there will be protesters and the anti-protesters. There's going to be anti-protesters that are there like, no, save the titties, man. I do know there have been phone calls made to the school that haven't been the most pleasant in nature. Set her position to HDSB Director of Education Curtis Ennis is to make sure she, the teacher, is protected and ensure that everybody remains safe. The son has reached out to the teacher for comment, but so far has not received a response. The teacher, who the son has decided not to name at this point, has not had any previous issues that have come to the attention of the board. We have had no phone calls prior to this saying anything about it, but having said that, Shuttleworth acknowledges there had to be some disconnect because one of the students created this video. Some of the concern has been expressed on social media, including one student taking it to Twitter to write, "The kids here most definitely don't think it's normal, but realistically, we can't say anything. Last year, the teacher was a man. I don't think the school can fire him." Yeah, okay. They found the one transphobic student. That's sick, man. Thank you, Toronto Sun, for doing your due diligence. In fact, Shuttleworth said the employee will be supported, adding the teacher is completely accepted and welcomed into the school community as far as the staff is concerned. Okay. No, I mean, just to fucking find a bra or something. That's crazy. The Sun is literally our Fox News. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, let's finish this fucking insane thing, by the way.
Pornography, which translates roughly into English as exploding milk porn.
Stop.
Hannah has been dressing like this for a while, but only recently have students within the school gone public with this fact. So they've been enduring this for a while. Kay also notes that Hannah's costume is based on a style of Japanese internet pornography, which translates roughly into English as exploding milk porn.
Stop. He did not just say exploding milk porn.
Which translates roughly into English as exploding milk porn.
Yo, what the fuck? I'm losing it, dude. This can't be real. Like, we wish this. Guys, we wish this upon the world. Like, this is not... this did not actually happen. I feel like I got zapped into a different timeline, dude. What the fuck? What the fuck, bro?
Pornography, which translates roughly into English as exploding milk porn.
I don't know what's going on. I got goosebumps.
So what's going on here? Well, you know exactly.
What's going on?
What's going on here? Let's stop pretending. Women may not see it right away because generally their lives are not defined by their sex drives. But if you're a man, you get it instantly. What is this about? It's about sex.
What? Wait, he didn't even go with like transphobia. What is going on? He literally is like talking about how hard he is. What the fuck? Bro, this, why did I didn't stop? I should have never paused this fucking clip. What the?
That Hannah's costume is based on the style of Japanese internet pornography, which translates roughly into English as exploding milk porn. So what's going on here? Well, you know exactly what's going on here. Let's stop pretending. Women may not see it right.
Bro, this is a Nick Mullen bit.
Away because generally their lives are not defined by their sex drives. But if you're a man, you get it instantly. What is this about? It's about sex. Stephen Hanna is enlisting other people's children in his sexual fantasies.
This is bananas. No, this is literally like, that is the weirdest, and I mean weirdest angle to take here. He just said like, I'm horned up for the teacher, and I know our children are too. No, that's wild. That was the photo that the chatter sent me, by the way. Tucker Carlson said those titties make me horny. I cannot believe it. What the fuck is going on? Stand up, Tucker, or pussy, what? Did he actually say exploding milk porn? Like did I just imagine that? Like did I watch that correctly?
So this week video surfaced.
I can't get over this, man. This is crazy. This is madness. Yep, search for exploding milk porn has skyrocketed. Yeah, no, this is real. This is a real thing that he said, man. That's...
place called...
Like, there are different ways... There are different ways to cover this, okay? Like you could have just been like, that's crazy. Come on, that's too much. Okay, that's too much. I genuinely don't get why people can't leave trans people alone. It feels creepy that they're always obsessed over me. I mean, like, the real reason why he's covering this, obviously, is to be like, all trans women are like this, right? Aiden owns you? What the fuck is this? Bammy season? He said it. I will be haunted by him saying that for a while. No, like, it was just... Oh, like, dude, I was watching this last night, by the way. But we'll talk about that in a second. Like, he could have very easily just been like, that's inappropriate. You know what I mean? Like, you could even be transphobic in a way that, like, I could have written this better for Tucker in a way that is, like, still transphobic and driving the point across without saying, I love them titties, and so do your children. Do you get what I'm saying here? Like, he could have just easily been like, this is how all trans people are. They're crazy. You know what I mean? He didn't even say that. He just straight up was like, Those titties are massive, and I like that, and your children too. Your children like that too. Like, we all like it. Men, we love those big-ass titties. Like, we are so horny for those titties. That's what he said. Which is the wildest way to cut this coverage, is like, wait, there's a second part to this? Did he actually say that? Do you want me to run it again? Here.
Exploding milk porn. So what's going on here? Well, you know exactly what's going on here. Let's stop pretending. Women may not see it right away because generally their lives are not defined by their sex drives. But if you're a man, you get it instantly. What is this about? It's about sex.
He says, stop pretending. You see those titties and you want to suck on them. What the fuck? That's crazy. Okay, give me more of this, though. I need to see more.
Internet.
Dog, you mean to imply it's a fetish for the trans woman, not for him, dude? No, no, no. No. That's a self-report, man. You are just hearing what you want. I don't get it. What he means by women not being defined by their sex drive?
It's hard to believe this is happening, but we're sad to tell you it's not just happening in Canada. You see versions of it everywhere, including in this country. And
stop. Is he going to find, like, the big titty teachers in America now? Is this like an epidemic? What's going on? Tucker's like, other channels like CNN refuse to tell you that there are big titty teachers everywhere. I mean, gigantic breastises, okay? Magumbos. What's going on? Americans used to look at big titties only in Playboy magazines, but now they're inside of your shop class. These calcium cannons have gone too far.
And to be clear, what this is, children being used as props in the sexual fantasies of adults. Children being used as props in the sexual fantasies of adults. Are you okay with that? Is any normal person okay with that? It's completely wrong. It's utterly outside the bounds of what's acceptable. It's not a close call. And yet suddenly teachers, licensed teachers, are bragging about it on social media.
I have had multiple students come out to me, not just with their sexuality, but also with their gender identity.
Yo, we need to let fucking queer people be cringe. Like, just calm down, dude. Like, just let them be cringe. Who cares? Straight people are cringe as fuck all the time, dude. What the fuck? Yo, I swear to God. It's so weird. It's like, they literally cannot comprehend a world in which, like, you just can't have, like, you just can't have a queer person be cringe, God forbid, anywhere on social media. That's like, boom, that's the responsibility of all queer people now. Holy shit. You get so mad. It's like, bro, you're annoying too. That's crazy. Yeah, he just cut the titty part. And then he's just now showing random fucking queer teachers being like, I talk about sexuality and gender. Okay, what's up? That's a teacher, man. What's your problem? Listen, all I'm saying is, unless their titties are fucking fat, she should not be in this article. Okay? That's all I'm saying. I better see some fat fucking titties right now, Tucker, or else you buried the fucking lead. What the hell is this? I mean, seriously, what the fuck? You can't just show exploding milk porn and then turn around and be like, look at this one. This one's got weird hair. Like, that's not the same. Stay on track, motherfucker. You promised big exploding milkers in our fucking schools, man. Where?
It's one of the reasons I think it's so important to be out and loud and proud.
I teach my elementary school students about gender identity.
Okay, what the fuck? This is, how? Bro, this is just irrelevant. You just debated us, dude. What the fuck? It's like the top of the hour is here, and I'm going to fucking tell you the ad break is coming, okay? That's a debate. At the top of the hour, there's a six-second ad break. If you no longer want to see those ads, if you want uninterrupted, broadcasted titties, okay? Uninterrupted. Not a single moment gone to waste. All you need to do is subscribe. You can do that for $5 or for free with a Twitch Prime. That's right. Twitch Prime is free. As long as you connect your Amazon Prime account to your Twitch account. Okay? That's right. It is. Or you can get gifted a sub. Donald Trump's Mar-a-Lago mate, thank you for the five, get the subs. Dr. Jen Vero, thank you for the five, get the subs as well. Oh. Allowing 10 people to no longer see the ads. Here's the one-minute ad break now. My wife says you're annoying, but goddammit. I for you, Hassan, Lep 7, Stan. Nolene Void, thank you for the five get did. I'm a trans children, childcare worker, sex ed teacher. Talking with kids about gender is literally so easy. They're so open-minded because they haven't been indoctrinated yet. Conservatives are making a mountain out of a molehill. No, that's the reason. Because children have not been indoctrinated yet. And because children do not have this like rigid gender binary understanding that is literally not even it's not built into the way that they see the world. And that's what they're terrified of, because then you can show them that gender is not as rigid. The fuck is this, Tomer? What did you do? Oh no. I get fucking canceled again. That's their fear. Their fear is that, you know, you can adequately teach children at an early age that so that the next generation is not as transphobic as the one prior, right? That's the main issue here. That's why they're fucking terrified. El Hassan, those kids are only in it for the clout.
Some people are girls, some are boys, some are both, some are neither.
I might tell this kid, we do have a flag in the class that you can pledge your allegiance to. And he like looks around, he goes, oh, that one.
So again, if you were walking through the park with your kids and a stranger came up and started talking to them, say to your fifth grader, your five-year-old, or even your 14-year-old about sex, what would you do? Well, you would call the police. Of course, that's not allowed. It's a crime because they're children. But teachers are allowed to do it and then to brag about it.
What? Are those teachers? Like, what's going on? I don't even know what's happening at this point. Two more parts if you want, part three and part four final.
You see, book.
No shot. And then he turns this into like the Boston Children's Hospital. That's psychotic. Teachers aren't random people in the park. Yeah, he's just like showing random clips of like drag shows and shit now. So, I mean, I don't want to see the rest of this even. Okay, yeah, the Boston Children's Hospital got like fucking bomb threats and shit, and it wasn't enough. So I think they just like want, more random fucking shit, like more people to get randomly upset.